Thank you all very, very much, and it's a pleasure to join you again on an important subject that's every day in the news and on the top of everyone's concerns about the future of our world and international security. And for those of you who've been fighting for the humanitarian cause of the people of Camp Ashraf and Camp Liberty, this has always been on the top of your agenda. Today we have a very distinguished group of panelists, and we'll speak about the many aspects of the struggle to continue to press the case for these issues. But there is one overarching message that will unify the many issues that we're going to discuss today. And that message is that whether you look at the issues we're going to discuss as national security issues, and whether you look at them as humanitarian issues, or whether you look at them as strategic issues, overall there is one answer. And that answer is an answer that's going to address the humanitarian concerns of those here. It's going to address the political and strategic concerns of those who are here. And it's going to address the national security issues of those who are here. And that issue is delisting the MEK so that it can continue to mount a strategic mission, which is to overthrow the mullahs in Tehran. Some of the folks here will speak about the politics of this. Some of the folks here will speak about the security issues. Some of them will speak about the humanitarian issues. I'd like to begin today with the issue of national security. And as I do, I'd like to read a letter from General Jim Jones, President Obama's former national security advisor, Commander Supreme Allied, Commander of Europe, Commandant of the Marine Corps. He represents so many that you'll hear from today and you've heard from in the past. He represents the issue of delisting the MEK is a national security issue in addition to humanitarian concern. He says, quote, "I join my colleagues in once again expressing disappointment in the devious manner in which the government of Iraq has conducted itself in the wake of near global condemnation of its behavior towards the people of Camp Ashraf and their move to Camp Liberty. Since the unprovoked attack on Camp Ashraf by the Iraqi armed forces in April of 2011, resulting in the deaths and wounding of unarmed men and women and children, the government of Iraq has increasingly revealed itself as not only being unappreciative of the enormous sacrifice made by the United States and its allies to bring freedom and hope for a better life for the people of Iraq, but it has also increasingly revealed itself to be a tolerant partner of the Iranian regime. It is important that the conduct of the government of Iraq be exposed for what it is, becoming a vassal state subordinate to the will of Iran. Nowhere is there a better example of this than in the cruel and callous handling of the people of Camps Ashraf and Liberty. Despite the efforts of many people and organizations around the world to bring attention to the plight of the several thousand people involved in this matter, the progress towards what would seem to be a relatively simple solution has been frustrated at every turn by a government which clearly sees it as being in its own interest to do so. It's time for this cruel cat and mouse game to stop and for the outrage of the world community to be felt by both Iraq and Iran. The United States has tried to play a constructive role in resolving this problem, but has had limited success thus far despite a daily effort of several interlocutors. Recently, a senior UN official has admitted that the United Nations reporting on the conditions of Camp Liberty were deliberately overstated and were not reflective of a reality which was much worse. The right thing to do, the humanitarian thing to do, is for the United States to remove the terrorist listing currently ascribed to the people of Camp Ashraf and Liberty, and to champion a program of third country repatriation as soon as possible. Thirdly, there should be a renewed effort by the United Nations to act as it is expected to act in such matters. And lastly, the United States and its like-minded allies should do whatever is necessary to alter the atrocious behavior of the government of Iraq in this manner. Jim Jones.